Let's talk about how DNA is replicated. And in order to understand that, it's important to review the structure of DNA. So let's take a piece of DNA that we have right over here, and let's just unwind the two strands. And then let's focus on a very, very small area in this double-stranded DNA, and that's the diagram that you're seeing in the middle. So the functional unit that makes up DNA is known as a nucleotide. And a nucleotide is made up of three components. The first is a sugar, or more specifically, deoxyribose. And deoxyribose is a derivative of ribose, another sugar, the one difference being that right over here there is an H instead of an OH, but in the central diagram I actually omitted all the OHs and Hs just for clarity's sake. And in the corner of the molecule, that blue O represents an oxygen, and I'm just mentioning that because typically a point would represent a carbon, but in our case it's just an oxygen. And we label the carbons. This carbon is 1 prime, this carbon is 2 prime, this carbon is 3 prime, this carbon is 4 prime, and this carbon is 5 prime. And you may have noticed that the sugars in the two chains are actually oriented in opposite directions. So if you look at the sugar right here, for example, the oxygen is pointing upwards, but in the corresponding nucleotide on the other chain, it's pointing downwards. So the two chains are running in opposite directions. Or another way to say this is they are anti-parallel to each other. Okay, the next component of a nucleotide is a phosphate group. And these are the purple P's that you see over here. And they connect the 3' prime carbon and the 5' prime, 5' prime carbon of two nucleotides. And the last component of a nucleotide is a nitrogen base. These are our A's, our T's, our C's, and our G's. So for example, here's a nitrogen base, and here's another nitrogen base. So this would be one nucleotide. This right over here would be another nucleotide. Notice each nucleotide has one sugar unit, one nitrogen base, and the phosphate group attached to the 3' prime carbon. So what happens when DNA is ready to get replicated? Let's see. Let's take our DNA chain and let's just orient it horizontally. And an enzyme will come along. This enzyme is DNA helicase. And DNA helicase effectively acts like a zipper. It's going to unzip or unwind our double-stranded DNA. And then another enzyme is going to come along. This enzyme is DNA polymerase. And DNA polymerase is going to start synthesizing new strands of DNA that are complementary to the old strands. So for example, on the bottom, it's going to synthesize a strand, and it's going to put an A over here, and a C over here, and a T over here. And then at the top strand, it's going to put a T over here, a G over here, and an A over here. And actually, come to think of it, I really should have drawn the A first, then the G, and then the T. You'll see in a few moments why. But anyway, what's the end result of all of this? Let's skip a few steps and let's see what happens at the end of this entire procedure. So we're going to end up with two new pairs of DNA, and in each pair there's going to be one strand that's from the original DNA that we copied, and then there's going to be one newly synthesized strand. So we call the old strand a parental strand, and we call the newly synthesized strand that DNA polymerase just put together the daughter strand. And this idea, this concept of the fact that each new pair has one strand that's from the old DNA and one strand that's new, is called semi-conservative replication. Let's talk about DNA polymerase. DNA polymerase works in very specific ways. So let's pretend that DNA polymerase wanted to elongate this chain here on the left. So a DNA polymerase has the ability to add nucleotides to a 3' prime carbon, so it would add a nucleotide right here. But it cannot add a nucleotide to a 5' prime carbon. So if DNA polymerase was elongating this chain, it would be doing so in this direction. Let's look at the chain on the right. Again, DNA polymerase can add a nucleotide to this 3' carbon, but it can absolutely not add a nucleotide to this 5' carbon. So if DNA polymerase were elongating this chain here on the right, it would be doing so in this direction. So the very, very important take-home message is that DNA is synthesized in the 5', 3' direction.